Let us pray. Our Father and our God, we bless your name for this wonderful day which you have made. We'll rejoice and be glad in it. As we go through your word, Father, we ask that you speak to us expressly. For your word makes us to understand that all scripture is given by the inspiration of you, the Lord God Almighty, and it is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, and instruction in righteousness, that the man of God might be made perfect and furnished unto all good works. Father, let this come to bear in our lives. Even as we study your word this day, we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Welcome you all in the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. We are in the Lenten season, and by the grace of God Almighty, we are treating the topic the Almighty God has revealed to Abraham. I'll be reading from Genesis chapter 17 and the first verse only. And when Abraham was 90 years old and nine, the Lord appeared to Abraham and said unto him, I am the Almighty God, walk before me and be thou perfect. The Lord bless the reading of his words in Jesus' name. This is just a simple thing that the Lord God Almighty wants to pass on to Abraham. You and I were created to know God. This is the ultimate purpose for our existence. And it is very important that we have a correct, a concise, an appropriate concept and perception of who our God is. For we tend to respond to him based upon our perceptions, upon our knowledge, upon the revelatory understanding of who we know, of who he is to us. God wants us to know him for every name that he bears. In this particular case, he wants Abraham to recognize him as the Almighty God. And that is why he came to Abraham and said, I am the Almighty God. Walk before me and be thou perfect. All he's just asking from Abraham is because he has appeared to him five times. And Abraham had been in the promised land for 24 years, awaiting God to manifest himself, to show himself based on the promises he has made to him. But for 24 years, it has not come. Abraham had ab initio known God to be Jehovah. But in this situation, God appeared to him as Jehovah El Shaddai, meaning the breasted one, the one that is all sufficient, the one that is the giver of life, the one that is the supplier of life, the nourisher, the fruitful one. He wants Abraham to see him in a new perspective. In our country, Nigeria, today, we need to see God in different perspectives as per our needs and desires. He appeared unto Abraham as the Almighty God. First, he wants Abraham to know that he is the life giver. He gives life to anybody who comes to him. He said, as many that comes to me shall nowise be cast away. He said, the thief cometh to kill, to steal, and to destroy. But I come that you might have life and have it more abundantly. He is the life giver. He, even when situations and circumstances surrounding Abraham pointed to the fact that Abraham could not bear anymore, God restored life unto him and made it possible for him to have a child and become fruitful and multiply. Furthermore, he is the supplier of all our needs. He is the one that is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we ask or think, because he is the great supplier. He said, he gives seed to the sower and bread to the eater. Furthermore, he is the nourisher. Sarah's body, by the age Sarah conceived, would have been declared to be dead. But God nourished her, replenished her, and brought her back, that she might be able to conceive and bear fruit. And furthermore, he is the all-sufficient, the one that can do all things. With God, there is no impossibility. What God wants Abraham to see is that he is the one that can do all things for him. Therefore, he revealed himself to Abraham at that instance as the Almighty God. coming to our country, Nigeria, coming to our church. What God wants us to know is that He is the Almighty, the one that is the all-sufficient, the El Shaddai, the life-giver, the supplier of our needs, the nourisher of our bodies, the all-sufficient one, the fruitful one. He said, walk before me and be thou perfect. How can you walk with God? Walking with God will require your faith. It is your faith that will make you please God. And when you please God, you become perfect before Him. That is what He was asking from Abraham. He said, walk before me and be thou perfect. He wants him to walk before Him in faith. For our walking with God requires faith. And without faith, it is impossible to please God. When you please God, He makes you perfect. And when He is perfect before you, He manifests Himself in all ways and in all areas that you want Him to manifest. I am praying for anyone listening to my voice this day, that the Lord God Almighty will manifest Himself to us. He will reveal Himself to us in new and dynamic ways, that our lives will never remain the same again. This country, Nigeria, will experience who the Almighty God is. And our church and the Christendom will experience the Almighty God in a new and dynamic way. Let us pray. Our Father and our God, we thank You. For Your word has come forth. Let it remold, let it reform, let it transform, and let it renew us. This we ask as we pray in Jesus' name. Amen.